Hey, how you doing? Well, I am trying to fulfill my promise and to make more videos on a consistent basis. I've been creating some artwork and I want to share some of those pieces with you, some new stuff. A lot of times when I'm doing art, I'll have some pieces lined up side by side and I'll do a little dabble here, a little dabble there. Over the before it really got cold around here, I got this huge piece of actually what it is a pool cover that someone gave me, and I cut it up. I mean, this was really big, but I cut it up into squares because then I placed all my artwork in the backyard, had paint all around, and really had a ball. And I had about seven pieces of canvas of different sizes on that tarp, and I was just going wild with color and everything. And even though I got a lot of like the foundation of how I thought things should look with the figures and the colors and all that, still I'm kind of working with some of those in progress. But I wanted to show you some of the ones that I kind of consider as close to possible being finished. I consider this video almost like you are a friend or a collector who just stopped by, and I was in the middle of working on some things. And I used to not let people look at work that's in progress, but I say, well, it's not that deep, because it gives me some type of immediate feedback in terms of what I'm working on, and allows people to kind of see how I do things. So let me show you this first piece. Now, I do not have names for any of these, so it's just some abstract stuff that I'm kind of having fun with, and but I am going in a certain direction with some of them. This one here was actually a spiral. There's a series of spirals that I was working with, in which, not sure which side I'll make it. This one really is unfinished. I mean, I'm just putting these fun shapes in it, and eventually I'm going to add a lot more detail. I mean, this is literally like a background in terms of what I'm doing. In fact, when I'm finished with it, it probably, or I shouldn't say probably, but it may not even have these circles, because I'm not happy with it at all. I was just having fun creating circles with the various paints and blending colors from the other pieces of canvas and the panels. Let's see here. This is another one. I'm gonna have to push this on the easel. Now, this particular one, I'm really vibing this because I began to see some pictures, some heads and so forth in it. And they weren't deliberate, so I was like, whoa, what's going on there? Down here in this region, here, I saw this somewhat of a muted silhouette of a figure. And I began to add more to it. But I plan to put some red in there and then mix it, because I love the spiral. And there's a lot of texture that I put in here. I had fun adding a lot more texture and to give it somewhat of a very slight relief. All in here, and I noticed that when I was doing this piece, had my jazz playing, my reggae playing, first jazz then reggae, and I began to get that bio vibe, in which I love starting with the spiral, like up in here, and then bringing that spiral on and connecting the spiral into other pieces, and once again, like that first image. This particular piece is really not finished. If someone even brought me cash and said, oh, I want to buy it, I love it the way it looks, I'm not satisfied with it. It doesn't have that moment in which I say to myself, this is complete. It's saying what I want to say. I do know I want to put a series of faces in it that kind of connect. I'm going through this head series of faces and things. This piece here in the easel, That piece I've been working with all summer, and it's somewhat of a continuation of a smaller piece which had a lot of pastel colors of different women that I had painted, well, actually side profiles of women in which it was mixed. And this, I'll show you that one in another video. But this particular piece, I'm dealing with the connection and or the reconnecting between body, spirit, and how literally we can be torn apart as individuals, but then we seek to try to become whole again. And we can't become whole while we're by ourselves, so we have to actually reconnect with other people. We have to find that the pieces that we lost within ourselves, and in many times when we find other people that have gone through experiences like we have, those are the actual things we latch on to, because we seem to sense this sense of familiarity when we see their pieces of torn past with our pieces of torn past, almost like pieces of puzzle, and reconnect. And I find that with a lot of my paintings, I'm basically putting back this puzzle. In my mind, I've thrown all the pieces aside, I've thrown them, and then I say, oh, I need to now get these shapes together and put them together. And almost like taking the dominoes, remember my Uncle Chuck played dominoes, and his hands would just move around those dominoes and then line them up almost magically, because his hands would move so fast. And that's the way I'm moving my paint and my images, because the dominoes for me are the images in my head, all those numbers that have to add up to something. And it's only by me continue to work with those pieces that I ultimately began to discover that's what I've been trying to get at. And there are times I will actually use that cartoon and then fill in the paint and all that, and that's fine. But then sometimes I just start with a blank canvas and say, I'm going to, in color, of course, and then bring all those colors together and say, I'm going to create the image that I see in here that are actually a shattered image, and then bring all those pieces together, piece by piece. And if you've ever done a puzzle, trying to put the pieces together, for some people aren't into puzzling, there is an excitement when you actually get to see the center or corner of that puzzle, and you know that if you keep putting those pieces together, eventually you're going to have one whole piece, one whole picture, and that picture will be the ultimate, it's showing you what you had. At the beginning you had nothing, you saw nothing, but if you look the bigger picture and then focus in on the smaller ones and how they connect, you will ultimately solve the puzzle. And perhaps that's all I'm trying to do as an artist, just bring pieces together from pieces that create one painting, or maybe all my paintings actually represent small pieces. And throughout my life, while remembering those paintings, all of those individual paintings, regardless of their size, will make up one big picture. And then I'll say to myself, oh, that's what life is all about. I'm old, I'm wrinkled, I got arthritis, but hey, I now see the picture. So I hope you come back and see some of my pictures. Have a great day.